Are you feeling guilty for saying no? Here are 7 steps for you to deal with guilt when you want to say no. Hi, I'm Katja. I'm a psychologist and psychotherapist from Slovenia, and I'm here to help you skyrocket your self-esteem. Make sure you subscribe so that you don't miss any of my new videos. The first step is to name how you're feeling. So name your guilt. Perhaps your first impulse would be to ignore it, but that can only intensify the guilt. Name your guilt and explore your feelings. The second step is to understand why saying no is hard for you. What are you worried about? Are you worried what the other person will think about you? Are you worried that they'll get angry? Or that they'll be sad or disappointed in you? Are you perhaps worried about the consequences that might happen if you say no? For example, getting fired, breaking up, or ending a friendship, and so on. What are some of the beliefs you have about yourself? Do you believe you must always be liked by everyone? Do you believe that you must always say yes, or that perhaps a woman should always say yes, or an employee should always say yes, and so on? The third step is to acknowledge that you cannot do everything. You have to say no to some things. And every time you say yes to some things, you are actually saying no to some other things. For example, let's say that your coworker asked you to do some extra work and to help her out. If you say yes to the coworker, you're actually saying no to, let's say, to your partner who is waiting for you at home. Or you're saying no to yourself, to resting and relaxing and having fun and stuff like that. So every time you say yes to something, you actually say no to some other stuff that you won't be doing at exactly that time. So let's say you said no to a friend who wanted to hang out with you because you're really tired and you need some time for yourself. And now you're feeling guilty because of it. So think about all the things you've said yes to by saying no to your friend. For example, you said yes to rest. You said yes to a free afternoon. You said yes to being well rested tomorrow and having an extra productive day at work because of it. You said yes to hanging another time when you'll actually feel like it and you'll be good company. You said yes to your wishes. You said yes to taking care of yourself. You said yes to yourself. So the next time you feel guilty for saying no, list all the things you actually said yes to by saying no. The next step is to remember that it's necessary for you to say no if you want to have a good relationship with this person. Saying yes all the time can actually hurt the relationship and you as well. Why? Because no genuine relationship was ever built on someone saying yes all the time. If you always say yes, 2 things will happen. The first thing that will happen is that you'll start resenting the other person for not realizing that you actually want to say no. And you might subconsciously start sabotaging your relationship by engaging in passive-aggressive behavior. For example, you might start avoiding that person, or you might forget to call him or her back. Or you might forget to do the thing that you promised to do that you don't want to do. You might even become sarcastic or unkind to the person. And this kind of behavior will hurt your relationship far more than just saying no. The second thing that might happen if you always say yes is even worse. You might start losing yourself. If you're always saying yes to other people's wishes, in time, you yourself might not even know what you want anymore or who you are. I've seen this time and again with clients who are people pleasers. They feel empty and emotionally numb. When I ask them what they want, they have no idea. They've been saying yes for so long and they've been ignoring their wishes, their values, and themselves, that they don't even know who they are anymore. So saying yes all the time will only hurt the relationship and you, and it's just not worth it. The fifth step for dealing with guilt when you want to say no is to think about the future. Now, let's say that your cousin wants to borrow $500 from you. And you know that he is terrible with money, and you know for a fact that he has a gambling problem. Other family members have already lent him some money and he's never paid any of them back. This is the first time he came to you for money. And frankly, you could afford to lend him money, but you don't want to. And now he's pressuring you to give in and to lend him the $500. Now, let's be real for a minute. The easiest way, by far, to get rid of guilt right now would be to just give in, to just lend him the money, and to not say no at all. This is the easiest way to get rid of guilt. But think about the future. If you give in, if you lend him the money, what happens next? Will this be the one and only time he's asking you for money? Despite what he might say, probably not. He'll probably keep coming back for more and more money. So, if you say yes and you lend him the money, you'll actually feel okay in this moment. You won't feel any guilt. But in the long run, you won't feel good. You won't feel good about yourself, you won't feel good about the situation. And you'll be always facing the same problem of him wanting more and more money. So think about the future. If you say no, on the other hand, and you refuse to give him the money, you will feel guilty for a few moments, or maybe even a few days. But in the long run, you will feel good. And your cousin will know that you are off limits, and perhaps he will even thank you one day for not enabling his addiction to gambling. So saying yes to somebody who is pressuring you can feel good. You can feel like you're a good person. So saying yes does offer immediate relief from feelings of guilt. But in the long run, you won't feel good because you'll realize that you were actually betraying yourself and your values. And the most important thing to remember is that it doesn't stop at just one yes. If you say yes, the other person will likely want more and more. If you say yes to your kids wanting chocolate before dinner, they'll probably want chocolate before dinner tomorrow as well. So when it comes to saying yes or no, don't just think about the here and now, think about the future as well. Another thing to consider is to think about how the other person is acting. Are they guilt-tripping you? Are they pressuring you into saying yes? Are they perhaps even threatening you? Some people are truly experts at guilt-tripping. They will make you feel like it's your fault when they feel bad. Let's say your mom invites you to come over and this time you say no. And then she says, "I'm all alone, nobody cares about me, you obviously don't want to see me and don't love me at all." How will that make you feel? You'll probably feel terrible. You'll feel like the worst son or daughter. And you'll feel very guilty. And this guilt might make you reconsider your no. Some people use guilt as a manipulation tactic. They try to pressure others to say yes by trying to make them feel guilty if they say no. I'll be making another video on different tactics of emotional pressures and guilt tripping, so make sure you subscribe so that you don't miss it. And the final step to dealing with guilt when you're trying to say no is to simply say no. So, how to say no? I've made a free mini ebook called 5 Super Practical Tricks for Saying No. I'll put the link down below so that you can download it and learn all these amazing tricks for saying no. So let me do a quick recap of how to deal with guilt when you're trying to say no. The first thing is to name the guilt, name how you're feeling. The second thing is to think about why you have trouble saying no. The third thing is to Remember that by saying no to some things, you're actually saying yes to yourself. The next thing is to remember that saying yes all the time can only hurt the relationship and yourself. The next thing is to think about the future, not just the here and now situation, but the future. The sixth thing is to think about how the other person is acting, specifically whether or not the other person is trying to guilt trip you. And the final thing, the final step, is to simply say no. So how do you deal with feeling guilty? Is it something you feel often? Let us know in the comments. Did you like this video? If you did, give me a thumbs up and make sure you subscribe so that you don't miss any of my new videos. You're also very welcome to join my free Facebook group called Skyrocket Your Self-Esteem. I really hope to see you there. Thank you so much for watching and see you soon.